Hello, everyone. Welcome to Sonorous Journeys 2, Episode 2, in an ongoing every 2 week webcast. And tonight is going to be all about the Crystalis or the children's tuning. And this is something that I've been working on probably for maybe 9 months or so. And it was kind of a commission given to me, but it's got an interesting story behind it. I was teaching a sound healing certification, and one of the students who went on to become certified, after the first 4 days, she decided she wanted to buy one of the angel harps that I was using to demonstrate the sacred geometry, and she took it and one other harp home. It was a fire and a water tuned harp, and she brought it home and started playing, and her children, and all five of them, clambered around and started listening to the music. And one of her daughters, who was very intuitive, very gifted, asked her mom, "Well, you have a fire and you have a water harp. Where is the ice harp?" And so her mom didn't have an answer, but she asked me, got on the text and see if I had any idea what an ice harp was, and I didn't. But I had an idea about the background of her child. She was very special. And so I started doing a little research and actually found an ice harp. I think it was somewhere in Iceland. A composer had created one out of ice. So I took a picture and sent that to her, and she showed it to her child. And the girl, she's 5 or 6, she said, no, that's not it. And so this went on for a while. I kept trying to find the perfect match, and I just was striking zeros. So I asked my wife, Carol, to kind of tune in and see what she could come up with this crystal, well, with this ice harp. And so she did, and a whole lot of information came through about this. And what she said was that the child was actually tuned into the vibrations of that were not of this world, and her intention was actually to help her sister who had kind of an affliction. And so she was really tuned into this what she called ice harp. But Carol said it was actually a crystal harp. This the ice was her way of expressing this. And the crystal vibration is very prevalent and prominent in this earth plane. And so as she was channeling this information through, what came through was that the was Archangel Michael came through, and he actually had a commission for me to work on this new tuning. And the tuning was in D minor, and it was a crystal tuning, and it was actually to help children, kind of in the footsteps of this child wanting to help her sister. So specifically, it was for helping children with autism, with Asperger's, with any kind of energetic afflictions that they might have come into the planet with, and also the other things that were having a bad effect on kids, like vaccines and so forth. So it was helping to clear that energetically from their field. And so there were some very strong instructions on how to create this music. Wasn't necessarily for angel harp, but it was in the D minor key. And the strong notes actually started on with the D72, which is a deep bass tone of the didgeridoo, and then went on down. And there are not too many instruments that play those very deep bass tones, so I decided that the keyboards would be a good way to go for that. So that's what tonight's going to be about, the Crystalis Tuning. And it's for the children, and also for the inner child. This actually works on aspects of the self that are kind of been hidden, kind of in the shadows, but yet can be healed. And so this D minor tuning is actually for children and for the inner child. So that's what we'll be doing tonight. So get yourself comfortable, close your eyes, and just kind of flow with the sound. Thank you very much. Have a good evening. Sleep well. See you in 2 weeks for episode 3.